Good morning. What a day for us to come and be together in worship. This is a day of thanksgiving and celebration. For what reason? Because today we are trying to have our worship in person. And yes, you are here, brothers and sisters. And I know that this we have gone a long way, and we're still trying to make sure that this place is really secured, safe, and we have all the measures that we do need in order to protect us from this COVID-19. But I'm sure that all of us here have received our vaccines. And that will really help us in making our in-person, a reality. So this is a Sunday that we do that, and still praying, looking forward that whatever are the things that need to be done in here, I will make sure that it is safe, it is for everyone, and we can continue to do our ministry together as a church. So I welcome you all who are here today. God bless you. And also for those who are in our Zoom right now, thank you for coming. We welcome you for all our guests and visitors who are here for the first time, both here in person and in the Zoom. We welcome you all. And I just want to say thank you for coming, Shane. You are the our guest today, and welcome. High five to you. And so these are the things that we are, into right now. Still having a lot in our head. But again, we got all of you who are here. Ati Nora is here. Ati Meli, she's brother Manny, and Ati Nita. And we have Ati Mila and sister Pam. And we have Ati Eunice. Then we have my brother Rod, brother 70, and JJ, and mom, and yes, Pastor June is here with us. And Kat, thank you very much. So what a blessing. Indeed, God is good. And all the time. I made some bulletins for all of you who are here right now to follow. And this is what we're gonna do. If you cannot read it on the screen, we have some help. All right. So with that, let us gather together with the gathering words. Take off your shoes. Shake off the dust. Together, let us worship God and receive Christ's teachings, that we may be renewed and strengthened to share God's love with the world. Well, if you're able, we're here right now. Let's stand and sing our gathering song.
Down there. mighty. All thy works shall praise thy name in earth and sky and sea. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God, three persons, blessed Trinity. Let us pray together this prayer of confession. Lord, we have depended on our own devices and means instead of trusting in you and your leadership. In our worldly ways, we have denied your power and refused to accept your loving help. We are like prodigal children as we have lost sight of your purposes for our lives. Forgive us, Lord. Proclaim. In Christ we pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, be seated. And now let us be in one spirit as we share our joys, our praises and concerns, our good news, being a community of faith. That maybe may we be in one, in love, and as we support and lift each other up and praying for one another. And so I'd like to ask our dear, our very own pastor, the Reverend John Cowley, to lead us in this ministry of prayer. Pastor June.
Good morning, everyone. JJ, can you possibly turn the, I could see the people on Zoom. All right, good morning. Happy 4th of July.
Yes.
Happy Independence Day and happy church anniversary as well. Yeah. We're supposed to kind of celebrate our church anniversary today. It is wonderful to be here today on our first worship together, worship service together in person after more than a year. God is good
all the time
for letting us able to worship virtually over the past year and for sustaining us all throughout this pandemic. And so we are truly, truly grateful. And so welcome back home. And those on Zoom, we also welcome you to our worship today on this first Sunday of July. I think before, you know, my heart is overflowing with gratitude for those who came last Sunday to clean our church,
yes,
to sanitize our church, to prepare everything. We thank you. Our church is like new because of your hard work. We thank those who cleaned the surroundings of our church, who clean our gardens, our plants, and everything. We thank you so much. That means a lot to all of us. That means that we love our church. As a small faith community, we are still alive, and we are still serving the Lord. And so for that, we are grateful. And for our also for our technician, for our audio and video, GJ, thank you so much. And Lil, thank you so much for doing an excellent job in making this our service, worship service, possible to be on Zoom and of course here now at church. So it's our time to share our blessings, our gratitude, and our prayer concerns. Anyone? Okay, Atinora.
That, you know, even when the time when we had to bring her over to the hospital, you know, I think that I was not panicking or anything, and it was on time. And because of, you know, the Holy Spirit really God guiding us and being with us from the house to the hospital and all the way in the hospital. Be praying for that and thank God that, you know, mom is well and now is here worshiping with us. Thank you very much for all your prayers.
Thank you for sharing that blessing, Ate Nora. Ina, thank you. We thank God you're here. Salamat sa Panginoon. At kayo po ay nandito ulit. At we thank God for answered prayers for you, Ina. God is good all the time. Yeah. Any other blessing? Of course, we'll continue to pray for Ina. Yeah. Anyone else? See, Ate Vanji Dipano, Mrs. Dipano.
Good morning, everyone. I'm so thankful to God that we have given the chance to be together after more than a year. And I would like to request to pray for my brother, Joe, who is suffering from severe allergy. Mm. And he was hospitalized. And I'm so glad to tell the members of our church that I have a friend here. Her name is Baby Yoma, and she accompanied me so that I could be able to come here and join the service. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ate Vanji. It's so glad to see you here, and thank you for bringing your friend Debbie with us today. And we'll pray for Kuya Joe. So we'll have a few moments as we offer this prayer. Oh, Holy God, we come to you praying for your blessing upon Kuya Joe as he recovers from allergic reactions, and we pray that you help him get better and feel better, oh God. And so please touch him with your healing hands and bring healing and wholeness and renewal to him. And of course, we continue to pray for Ina as she continues to recover, and we pray that you heal her fully as well. We pray for those who are still recovering from illnesses, those who are sick at home in the hospital. We pray for your healing touch upon them as well. We offer this prayer to you, Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Anyone else? Eunice.
Thank you for being here this morning, brother. Last Wednesday, I have a doctor's appointment, and the worst part, the news that I heard is not good. But I need your prayer because I'm having a glaucoma.
You're having a what?
Glaucoma.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yes, so I hope and pray that God will restore my eyes right there. But yeah. I need your prayer. Please continue praying for me.
Of course, Manang Eunice. Thank you for sharing that concern. So Manang Eunice is saying that she is having glaucoma. She has been diagnosed with glaucoma, and she asks our prayers for her eyesight to be restored. So let us offer prayers for Manang Eunice. Oh God, you have heard Manang Eunice expressing her need of prayers. And so today we pray for her, Lord, and we pray that you touch her eyes and take away this glaucoma, and so she will be able to see clearly again. And so please restore her eyesight, and so she could enjoy a good quality of life. She will be able to come to here at our church to serve you more and to participate in our ministry. And we pray that you sustain Manang Eunice now and help her stay healthy and well as well. And so we offer this prayer for Manang Eunice. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Anyone else?
Yes. Hi, Pastor.
Yes.
Is this Joyce? Good morning.
Yes, Joyce.
I am so happy to see people in the church now. And with that, we were supposed to be there today, but my mom was rushed to the hospital on Thursday, and she was bleeding, and this is due to her diverticulosis, which is now a diverticulitis. Mm-hmm. So She has been bleeding. There was some blood clots, and they're still trying to find out where this is coming from. And I just wanted to let you know that she is, I don't know where her strength is coming from, but she's okay. But the only thing is, we're still waiting for what the doctor is going to do. She has not been eating, but she has the fluid. But from time to time, they had to stop it because they wanted to watch her, the water intake in her body as well because of her heart. So there are many things that they really have to be careful of. So they're deciding to take out her blood thinner because that might be one of the things that causes her to bleed. So I spoke to her yesterday because she was in isolation. And right after this service, I'm going to go see her. But she is pretty strong. As of last Friday when I saw her and when I spoke to her on the phone yesterday, she is okay and she's asking for a prayer. So can we ask the church to pray for her?
Of course. We have actually started praying for her during our Bible study, Joyce. And we continue.
Thank you.
Of course. So we'll offer a prayer for her, of course, again today. Let us pray for Manang Luz. Oh God, we come to you again praying for your continued blessing upon Manang Luz. We're sorry that she's still in the hospital. And we pray, though, that you please continue to touch her with your healing hands and renew her body. And that all the treatments and medication she is receiving be your instruments of bringing comfort, renewal, and strength even, and especially your gift of healing upon Manang Luz. Let her know in her alone time at the hospital that we are with her in spirit and in love, and that this prayer that we're offering to her may be felt by Manang Luz in this moment. We pray for your blessing upon Joyce as she continues to support Manang Luz. Give Joyce the strength she needs every day as well. And so we offer this prayer to you, Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayers. Anyone is Atinita? Yes.
Yeah, please continue to pray for my health, because until now, all my appointments are canceled. Because I'm still enrolled in Blue Cross. Mm-hmm. I don't know how I became a member because they said this is a scam. So until now, I cannot go to my doctor because of canceled. Yeah. So please pray for me.
Of course.
We have been calling Blue Cross and they don't answer.
Yeah.
Oh. They said this is a scam.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Atinita, so thank you for sharing us that concern, Atinita. And so we come to the Lord. We pray, O God, for your continued blessing upon Atinita. And we pray in your holy name that this issue of health insurance will be resolved soon, and that you please intervene in this problem, O God. And we pray that as Atinita waits for this resolution of this problem, that you continue to sustain her and help her stay well and healthy. And we pray that soon she will be able to make her doctor's appointments. And so be with Atinita now. We offer this prayer to you, Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Anyone else? Those in the Zoom, do you have any
Pastor
prayer?
Jude?
Yes, Lil.
I do have something. Good morning, everyone. I'm so happy to see all of you who are in attendance today. So I'm envious, but at the same time, I have to be cautious. Yeah. So anyway, two prayer requests. This Thursday, we're doing our San Francisco Night Ministry as well. And praying that there will be enough volunteers once again. Everyone is welcome. Those of you who are not working and are not busy, please join us at 10 o'clock on Thursday morning. Mm-hmm. The other thing is, please continue to pray for my uncle. I know we've been praying for him, Uncle Augusto, who is in Florida. His surgery, his colon surgery, is this Wednesday, the 7th.
Yeah, thank you, Lil, for sharing that concern. So let's come to the Lord and offer these prayers. Lord, we thank you for this ministry of supporting the San Francisco Night Ministry, where we could be a part of extending your love to our community, especially to our brothers and sisters who are homeless in the city, in our community. And we pray that you continue to touch our hearts and our lives so we could make the time to volunteer on Thursday to prepare sandwiches, bags, and at the same time to enjoy the fellowship of working together in fulfilling this ministry. And so we pray that you continue to bless us, continue to bless this ministry in our community. And of course, we continue to pray for Tatang Augusto, who will be having surgery on Wednesday. We pray, oh God, that you please give him a calm heart, a calm spirit, and let him know that you are by his side, and help him to have a successful surgery and recovery, oh God. And of course, we pray for your continued healing upon him as well, and that you help him recover fully and heal him and cure him, oh God. Bless his family and loved ones as they continue to support him as well. So we offer this prayer to you, Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Anyone else?
Pastor, just a praise report for the hearts and the joyful spirit of those volunteers and board, the Board of Trustees as they continue to do our project at the parsonage.
Yeah.
And looks like it's going great. And just want to commend them for their willing hearts, led by Brother Rod Pasalo.
Yeah, I know.
And he's here with us. Brother Manny.
Yeah.
The extra mile that he did yesterday to just coat the floor,
yeah.
What a blessing. And also for Brother Carville and Brother Vic Manuel and Brother Elmer Lacerna and Sister Lillian and the rest. What a joy for me to see them. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for that celebration and for that praise. The Board of Trustees, you are stellar, outstanding board for continuing, for continuously, you know, finishing our project and our parsonage. And of course, Brother Rod, and of course, everyone, you've already mentioned Pastor Alex. So thank you so much for all your work. And we'll continue to pray for this project as well. Do you have any prayer requests, concerns as we close? All right, if we don't have any concerns, let us close with our prayer. Let us pray then. Oh God, we thank you that we have this Board of Trustees in our church that's so active and still alive in the midst of pandemic and continue to work in finishing our project at the parsonage. Thank you for its members, leadership, and we pray that you continue to inspire our Board of Trustees members and every one of us to be able to share our time, our efforts, and even our resources to continue to support our church and its programs and ministry. And even as we celebrate our church's anniversary today, we don't have much to, we don't have any activity to celebrate today, oh God, but we're still thankful.
Yes,
for sustaining our church all these years, so that even now we're still alive and active and doing your work in bringing change in the lives of your people, as well as bringing your love and compassion to our communities and to those that we meet in the ways of life, oh God. And so we pray that you bless our church that as we face this coming year and many years to come, that you journey with us, and we pray for our pastor, our lay leaders, every member of this faith community, that you continue to bind us together so that we may continue to work together, knowing that we are called to be your body, your living body in the world, making disciples not only within our walls, but also making disciples for the world, for the transformation of the world. And so we are grateful, oh God. And even now, as we celebrate our Independence Day as a country, as a nation, we thank you for the freedom that we have, the freedom to worship, the freedom to work, the freedom to learn and to study, the freedom to express our opinions, the freedom of speech, the freedom of religion, all the freedom that we have. We are grateful that we have this freedom that comes from you. Help us to use our freedom responsibly by being loving and caring and compassionate to one another, and being able to listen, to acknowledge and to honor each other's freedom and dignity, and respecting each other, oh God. We pray for your blessing upon those who are defending our freedom, those brothers and sisters who are serving in the armed forces, oh God. Lord, we do not know them, but we do know that you know them by name, oh God, and we pray that you please protect them as they continue to defend and preserve the freedom that we have. And for family members who are serving in the military, we pray for them, oh God. And so we offer all this prayer to you, Lord, trusting that you listen to us as we commit our lives to you now. And so I invite you to spend a minute to offer your personal concerns, your personal thanksgiving to God, and offer these concerns in the silence of your hearts in this moment. We ask all this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Pastor, for blessing us in that ministry. Let us continue to be in the spirit of worship and respond to our Lord's Prayer with a song, and to be accompanied by us by a cat.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus,
now let us listen to the reading of the scriptures through a video.
And he marveled because of their unbelief. And he went round about the villages teaching, and he called unto him the 12 and began to send them forth by two and two, and gave them power over unclean. Out from thence and came into his own country, and his disciples followed him. And when the Sabbath day was come, he began to teach in the synagogue. And many hearing him were astonished, saying, From whence hath this man these things? And what wisdom is this which is given unto him, that even such mighty works are wrought by his hands? Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, the brother of James and Joseph, and of Judah and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us? And they were offended at him. But Jesus said unto them, A prophet is not without honor, but in his own country, and among his own kin, and in his own house. And he could there do no mighty work, save that he laid his hands upon a few sick folk and healed them. And he marveled because of their unbelief. And he went round about the villages, teaching. And he called unto him the 12, and began to send them forth by two and two, and gave them power over unclean spirits, and commanded them that they should take nothing for their journey, save a staff only, no scrip, no bread, no money in their purse, but be shod with sandals, and not put on two coats. And he said unto them, In what place soever ye enter into an house, there abide till ye depart from that place. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear you, when ye depart thence, shake off the dust under your feet for a testimony against them. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. And they went out and preached that men should repent. And they cast out many devils, and anointed with oil many that were sick, and healed them.
Thank God we were able to listen and hear it loud and clear, though we have just encountered some technical difficulties. But thank you very much, Sister Lillian, and for our tech crew. And for that, let us respond the word of God for God's people. Amen. Amen. And for that, before I share you the message, let us share a message through a song to be rendered to us by the Baluyot family.
This is all my hope and is all my righteousness, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. I know, on the fount I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Are you
be the glory. Thank you, dear Baluyot family. How can we say thank you deep in our hearts, but may God continue to bless you. You are an inspiration in our ministry. So may God continue to keep you strong, healthy, and with the love of the Lord, so that the good news is being shared to reach out people who need the Lord. Well, this is the first time after 1 year and 6 months, is that right? That we have not seen the place, seated on your favorite space, and be on those pews. But thanks be to God. Well, I know I'm gonna take Sister Lillian's stuff that said she envies being here today. Yeah, you should be, all of you there at the Zoom room. But we feel that God is here, God, and we feel each other's a spirit, the fellowship that we're having. But you know what? Wherever you are, the Spirit of the Lord is there. And I know there will come a time that you can come here, and all of us together. Let's pray that will come soon. And the young people and the youth, when they were here, along with Sister Atinora, Sister Lillian, my better half, Vanji, along with the young people and young adults, they were so excited that they can really, that they can give their time and they're all to serve the Lord. And they said, Pastor, and we would like to do our youth and young adult Sunday on the 29th of August. Look at that. And actually, they were the ones who were pulling all the weeds. Though sometimes they said, which one is weed and which one is a flower? So that kind of response, but they're there. You know, focus and just grab whatever they can grab and clean the surroundings. An expression of how grateful they are to see the place and being tended to, because they value not only these four walls, but they value the ministry that we are really entrusted with. And so church leaders, brothers and sisters, friends, members, young adult, children of the church, rise up and let us come together, roll our sleeves, and go and share the good news to the world. And that's what faith is all about when we encounter the Lord Jesus Christ in our lives. So today, just a lot of wonderful things that are happening. First time to see the place, it's Independence Day, 4th of July, and then it's our church celebration. It's an anniversary. But looking forward to have, this is not the first and the last for us to do these things, especially our celebration, but it is the opening for us to start afresh and keep the spirit going. And I know these are the future of the church. And I know that each one of you has already come to know the Lord, and he has set a plan for you. And that plan is to widen his kingdom here on earth and for you to share God's love to the world. And what else can I say? But it's the faith that you have that shows how much you know the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, if you know the Lord Jesus Christ, that means to say it is equivalent to your responses. So if you know the Lord, you got a response. And if you know the Lord this much, this is your response. If you know the Lord this much, then this is your response. So I would like us all again to come and revisit the scripture reading that has been shared to us today. And in this reading, you know, it is very relevant and very timely for us as we experience transitions in our lives right now. And let us again look into what Jesus did. When Jesus was going around preaching and teaching, the message he was sharing was very radical. And it is really, it really pinched the hearts of people. And people were watching and waiting for a prophet and a Messiah. And so for someone to claim to be the Messiah on those days was a big mistake, was a big deal in and of itself. But Jesus' message was especially very unique because it was not the message the people were expecting. They thought the Messiah would be a hero for them who would smite their enemies, you know, to vindicate them. It was never expected that the Messiah would come saying, he must die. He must die at the hands of his enemies. So imagine that the Messiah would come saying he must die at the hands of his enemies. So if that is the Messiah, then it's no of use. So that's part of the reason that Jesus gave his disciples these instructions about preaching and teaching and shaking the dust from their feet when the message was rejected. But here's the thing. Even knowing that his message was that radical and popular, Jesus preached it anyway. There's no reason not to. Even with the understanding that his disciples would not be well received in every place, he sent them to preach and teach anyway. The call to repent and enter God's kingdom was very important, and Jesus knew it, and he knew that message must be shared, even if it offended. And here's the thing, my dear brothers and sisters, that message is just as vital today, as important 2,000 years ago. And you know what? That message of God's kingdom is still just the same, very offensive today as well. Unfortunately, it seems that because of that span of time, many years passed, looks like it has softened the call of Christ and the urgency of the message. And that's what we experience right now. We don't want to offend people, do we? So rather than taking the message to the world and shaking the dust off our feet when we are rejected, we have decided we're just not going to share the message anymore. I hope I'm wrong. But the problem, though, is that church isn't like it used to be. Right? 70 years ago or 8 years ago, anyone had to do was just open the door. Open the doors of a church and people would flock, eager to listen, you know, come to the church. And the church is full packed. Yeah? But now, people are not flocking to churches the way they used to. So that means that if they are to hear the life-changing message of Christ, we have to take it to them right where they are. The world has changed. The generation has changed. And it doesn't mean to say that if the world has changed, the word that needs to be preached and need to be shared is not only within the four walls of the church, but for us to gather and bring it, share it to people. There's no reason that we have to be stagnant. There's no reason why we just keep it here. You know, we keep it here. And it's not a reason, just like a medicine cabinet, that if you need a medicine, just take it when you need it. But that's not the way how the gospel needs to work. God has already called us and entrusted us, and we got hands, we got feet, we got a heart that needs to be shown to the world. That the heart that we have, the reason why we serve, the reason why we give, share the gospel, it's because we have the heart of God. We have Jesus Christ in our lives. Because we have known him this much, and we need to share God's love. We need to reach out to the world. But there's even more to this work we are called to do. Even as we work at sharing Christ's message in the world, we also have to believe that Christ has the power to change lives. It's not us, brothers and sisters, to do that. Our business is to share the good news. And it's up to God to change and transform the lives of people, as God, as Jesus Christ transformed me and you. It's not the pastor. It's not the workers, it's not the committees, the church leaders who are the ones who change lives. And to you, brothers and sisters who responded to the call, being leaders, and to us pastors, this is our reminder that we don't need to take credit of changing other people's lives. It is the Lord. So every time we go out and serve and share our time and our abilities, this is for the Lord. And we do it in the name of the Lord and nothing else, no more, no less. To you, young people, how much do you know Jesus in your life? This much? I implore and I pray that you come and let us help each other together in sharing the love of the Lord to others. We need you, and God needs you. The church needs you. The ministry needs you. And to you, my dear, mothers and fathers, the older folks, don't say that you have done this and done that. God still not given up on you yet, and there's still a lot of things that need to be done. You have gifts and graces that we would love to see happen to us younger ones. We would love to see you share. Give what God has given you and is giving you. I don't think that God's blessings has already stopped. And it is only meant for younger folk. But the blessings of God continues whoever you are, regardless of your age, regardless of your race, regardless of your status in the society. God has given you a lot of blessings. You need to share that. You need to preach the good news. You need to preach Christ, how God has transformed your lives, how God has made you a new being, a new creation, that the power of the Holy Spirit is enabling you and empowering you to go and do the work. Don't stop when people laugh at you. Don't stop when people reject you. Don't be ashamed of the Jesus that you have known. Let it show. You know, whatever situations you are into, bring the good news. Share the love of God, love of Christ to the world. You know, the kind of evangelism that Jesus has called us, his disciples, to is not easy by any means. It requires us at times to step out of the comfort zone of our church and our circle of friends, and to be in places where we might not normally go. And without all the amenities, the perks, you know, the comforts of normal life, Jesus tells us that we are to leave behind all but bearers of necessities and to rely on the blessings of God through others. We just got to believe. We have to have faith in the power of the risen Christ and our own abilities as disciples sent by the same Christ. I think that when we really get down to it, we will find that we are capable of facing even the toughest of situations. Amen with that? When we believe this and live like we believe it, then truly great things are possible. See the pews in there? When we do Christ's command, sharing the good news, we will not worry of who's going to be sitting next to you. We will not be worried about who's going to do the ministry. But make sure, brothers and sisters, that don't leave the ministries to only the pastors and a few of our leaders. Count on yourselves and say, how can I offer? What can I offer, Lord? And how can I share this? One thing, it's not me who save you. It's not the leaders of the church who save you, but it is the Lord Jesus Christ who save you. So you are not here to respond and say, I'm going to serve the church. It's not the church who saves you. Maybe the church has led you to Christ. That's the important thing. So it's the church who is very instrumental in bringing you to Christ. Let this be the heart of each one of us. Great things will come to us because we believe in Christ. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. And for that, let us thank God and respond and share the blessings that God has put on our lap. And whatever blessings that is, be it pledges, tithes, offerings, let us give it to the Lord and say, Lord, you are good. And what we're going to do is that can make your pledges prepared, because later on, as you come to partake of the communion, there is an offering plate that is right there on that spot. And you may drop it there. And after that, you may come and get your own cup. I'll put it on each side, those cup plus the bread, the wafer. It's all in one item. So you have to open it. And on top of it is the wafer. And then the inner one is the juice. So each one will receive. So as we prepare our hearts for that, let us hear a song from Brother Rod.
Good morning, everyone. As the world looks upon me, as I struggle on, they say I have my heart, I chose a way. Thank you.
Let's pray together. And let us pray the one that is on the screen. Jesus Christ, you teach us to look for your presence and power in the midst of vulnerability and need. May those who receive the gifts we have given experience your power in new and amazing ways. May your prayer heal them. The name of the one who shared their life. Amen. I'd like to invite you all now to be in one with me as we prepare ourselves in partaking of the bread and the cup. Let's start with a great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you and lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It's right to give our thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You form us in your image and breathe into us the breath of life. When we turn away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. He healed the sick, fed the hungry, and ate with sinners. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. When the Lord Jesus descended, he promised to be with us always in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. And on the night of which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And when the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you and gave it to the disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of this, your mighty act in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here And on these gifts of bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all this world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with his Holy Spirit in your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. The body of Christ, even for you. The blood of Christ, shed for you. Amen. Now I would like to invite all of you to partake of this symbols of Christ's body, Christ giving his blood shed for us all. We will put these elements on the top of the railing, and each one of you do come and get one of each. And after partaking it, as you do that, before you open this one, there is a thing in there that you have to open for you to avail of the wafer. Then the second one is that you have to peel it off, avail of the juice or the wine. And then as you come to the altar, one after another, you may drop your offerings. You have the envelopes that are available on the pews. You can put your name and the reason why you give, but I'm sure that you're giving it because you want to praise God and to thank God for everything. Blessings. And so drop it on the side. There is an offering plate. Then after that, you may come and get the elements. And then you want to pray, you pray silently, and you may use the center aisle to come and use the side aisles as you go back to your seats, as we are being led by our hymns, led by Sister Catherine at this time. Thank you. Before I do it my own, I'd like to know, I want to make sure that our brothers and sisters who are on the Zoom are able to receive communion with our usual way of doing it. If you have something that you have prepared there, I give you this moment to do it along with me as I open this cup and eat the bread and the wine. So let us all come together and to partake with it. I'd like to ask each one to be in a moment of silence as we pray and give thanks to God. Thank you, Lord, saving our soul. Thank you, Lord, making us whole. Thank you, Lord, for giving me a great salvation, so rich and so free. Amen. Let us now sing our closing hymn. We have it on the screen. Here I am, Lord. This is a hymn that if you feel like it is speaking to you and you feel the nudge of the Holy Spirit, please don't be shy. Just be open to it. And if you want to respond, because the Holy Spirit says, you have to forgive somebody who hurt you, or you ask forgiveness because you have hurt somebody else as well. If the Holy Spirit says that it's convicting your soul, that you want to renew your life and relationship with the Lord, this is the time for that as well. Please open your heart to Him. And if if you are being nudged by the Holy Spirit because you want to respond and serve Him in special ways, this is also the right time for that. And also, if you want the Lord to be in your life, accepting Him as your Lord and Savior, please do so. This is a time for that. And if you feel like you're led, please do stand and as a way of letting God that this is what you wanted to do. Let us sing our closing hymn.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I've heard my people cry. All who dwell in deepest sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night. I will make this darkness bright.
Yes, Lord, here we are because we have heard your call. We have heard your call to be here today because we need you, because we have missed you, because we have felt your love. And so we offer to you our thanksgiving, our gratitude, for the many blessings you have given us, especially for sustaining us, and especially for giving your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us and who has come back to life for us, so that his death and resurrection, as presented or represented through the Holy Communion, has become our salvation, has become our life abundant, not only in this world, but in the life to come. And so you see your children here kneeling and those standing in the congregation. Lord, you know them, you know their hearts. We pray, oh God, that you touch them, touch their lives, touch their bodies, touch their spirit, touch their hearts, that they may feel your renewing and transforming power, that they may feel your promise that you will never leave them alone in times of joy, in times of challenges, in times of pain and suffering, in times of needs of life. Remind them that you are the provider, that you provide them the things they need, especially good health and good life. And so as they renew their relationship with you, O God, may you be born anew in their lives, in their hearts. As you are as you may born again, as you may you be born again or born anew in everyone's hearts and lives today. And so we pray for all of us here now, O God, even those brothers and sisters attending our service on the Zoom, touch their lives as well, O God. Any burdens that we carry, please lighten them up and remind us once again that indeed you never, never gave up on us because you love us just as we are. And so we commit our lives to you now, even as we face this coming week, journey with us. May you be our light. May you be our hope. May you be our strength. May you be our guide. And may you be the center of our lives. Thank you, Lord. This we pray once again in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Shall we all stand up now as we sing the last verse of our hymn?
By the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a wreath for them, a hand will set. A nice bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. When shall I say, here I am, Lord? Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the dark. I will go, Lord, if you need me. I will call your people in my arms.
Brothers and sisters, what a joy and a blessing for us to come and meet here today. I hope that we will continue this one, but right now we are looking into how we can make this place a better, a safer place for all of us. And please be informed. We will keep you posted and updated regarding whether we are going to continue next Sunday and the following Sundays. But make sure you will hear from us and go from there. And we are actually praying and hoping that on the last Sunday of August that we will have it officially open. So with what we have right now, this is a good sign. Let's pray to the Lord that this is what we have done today is because we have already received what needs to be done for protocols. Vaccinated or not vaccinated, you have those things that need to be done. The sister Nora Atinora will have something to say.
Pastor, you heard what Pastor has been announcing. So we were trying to do the, you know, what is supposed to be done. But today, we can see that there's more people who came. So maybe we ask them, Pastor, if it's okay if we can gonna continue on, or we still have to go close it.
To those of you who have come, you will receive updates between now and the week. So if we go ahead, it's open. I will let them know. We will call you and let you know if you can, if our church is open this coming Sunday. So we don't want you to be left behind for what's for our information and updates. But anyway, receive the blessing of the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you, give you peace, not only at this time, but until we meet again. Go. Amen. Let us now pass the peace of Christ with each other. The social hall is closed, but thank you very much for that.